Good morning, Oxygen Life. It's great for me to be able to share a word of encouragement with you guys this morning. Brad, to you and the elders, thank you for allowing me to speak into the life of the church. I'm really excited, you know, about what God has put on my heart. Currently, I'm busy with the letter to the Romans. And last night, just before I fell asleep, I just really felt the Lord spoke to my heart on how do we live our lives being at home. You know, I think a lot of people like myself, you know, the world is out there and we love to live our lives out there. So it's either cycling or running. Maybe some guys like hunting. And there are those who like to tease the sharks in the sea. And I know a few of them in your church taking their surfboards onto the water. But the reality is, you know, we love to live out there. I know a few people that literally travel the world on a regular basis. And all of that has changed in a very short period. So we are all at home and we live our lives in the confinements of our houses, our homes. And the question is, while we are at home, how do we live our lives so that it will be God honoring? Reading the letter to the Romans, I just felt it's so applicable to our own lives. You know, the world at the time then was very much as it is today. And we live in times where we can see, you know, the world is caught up in sin and the world really don't care about morality. There's a total disregard for morality. And the letter speaks about people being lost in sin. And we all know that a lot of people on a daily basis die in sin. And that doesn't mean that they just physically die. They die a spiritual death. So for us that are followers of Jesus, how do we live our lives now that's honoring to God? And I ask the questions because I know a lot of people that say to me, you know what? I love being useful to the Lord. And being useful means to be out there, you know, being at church, serving at church, you know, serving at the coffee shop, serving in the worship team, serving in the children's ministry or in the prayer or whatever way, leading a com group. Obviously, that is a way of just living out my love towards the Lord and in gratefulness for what He's done for me. But there's a difference. Some people don't feel useful when they're at home. Now their life don't feel as if it has any meaning. But how? Let's just try and understand, how do we live an honoring life to God while we are at home? I do understand. Maybe I should just say this. You know, I think I understand what it means to be at home and just being stuck at home. Lizette, that's my wife, and myself, we just returned from a country in the Middle East where we visited people that are serving the Lord and serving the kingdom in by what they do under very, very difficult circumstances. And the moment we set foot in South Africa, we had to stay in isolation for 2 weeks. And during the last week, the lockdown came. So we've been at home for more than 3 weeks. But it's fortunately, it's not just the two of us. We have our children and the grandchildren at home. So it's wonderful to have them at home and we're very busy, but it's great. And the question is, you know, why we do our daily chores, why you take out the garbage, why you prepare food, while you wash the dishes, or while we play with the grandchildren, or if I catch myself being in the workshop, how is any of that honoring to God? And I think the answer lies in Romans chapter 8. You know, this letter starts off by telling us about people and the condition of people's hearts and their lives, everyone being in sin. Says there's not one that's not out without sin. But then you're actually being surprised late in this letter when it speaks about God freely from His side giving us life. You know, freely from His side giving Jesus to be reconciled with us again. You know, the whole thing about the ministry of reconciliation, freely from His side, us not doing anything. We just have to accept that in faith. And that's just such a big surprise. You know, when we talk about sin, often people think that you can only sin when you are, not only, but most of the time we sin when we are with people. You know, the way we act or react, the way we treat people, or what we do when we are with people. And Matthew 18 actually speaks about that, that when someone sins against you or sin against you, how do you respond to that? How do you treat someone like that? But primarily, we sin against God. And, you know, so we must be careful in this time that we are at home, you know, just getting in, you know, just being laid back, find ourselves or maybe being caught out, being in sin because we are at home and in the confinements of our home, catch that we are in sin. And I think it's all up to you and me. How do we open ourselves to be tempted in whatever way? Although we are at home, we still have the world out there through the internet. And what do you open yourself to in this time? Because before you know, you can open yourself to sexual temptation. You can open yourself to violence or to horror or whatever it might be that's not honoring to God. Even in this time, there are so many preachers out there on the internet, and you can open yourself to doctrine that's really not sound doctrine that the Bible speaks about. I think, you know, it gives us the two sides in Romans 8. It speaks about the life in the flesh and the fleshly desires, or the earthly life, or the life in the spirit. And I think, you know, it's very clear that if we allow the Holy Spirit, if we surrender our lives to the Holy Spirit, we will experience a total metamorphosis, like we see in the life of a butterfly. You know, this morning, actually, I was out there in the garden playing with my grandson. And this year, I don't know for what reason, there must be plants in the garden that attracts butterflies. And it just reminded me that a butterfly starts off with being a little larvae or a little worm. And it ends up being this beautiful creature we call a butterfly. But it goes through a whole process of metamorphosis. And we can experience that in this time if we allow the Holy Spirit to change us. You know, instead of dreading the fact of being at home, rather allow the Holy Spirit to change us. Romans 12 speaks about, you know, let God change you by the way, you know, surrendering your thoughts to Him. And if you allow Him, He can change you just by changing the way you think. And I think being at home, spending time with the Lord, we all have been speaking about this, spending time with the Lord in prayer, you know, and in worship, reading the Word, but also just in the way you prepare food, the way you spend time with those that you love. In our situation, spending time with our grandchildren and our children, that can be honoring to the Lord. You know, 1 Corinthians 10, verse 31 says, "So whether you eat or drink, or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God." So you can honor God by, you know, just by preparing food, just washing the dishes. But what your mind is busy with can be honoring to the Lord. So it's easy for us to fall in a rhythm of, you know, this destructive rhythm. And with that, I'm meaning you're not focusing, not living a focused life. And I'm not talking about lying on the couch, just taking a rest. I'm talking about, you know, not focusing. I think this is really a time of focusing on surrendering ourselves yet again to the Lord to do a wonderful work in us. And I think it can also be a time of preparation for us, you know, so the moment, you know, the world opens to us again, that we can see this as a time that we've been prepared, that we can step out into the world like a mighty spiritual army that's been prepared for whatever is lying ahead of us. So this is my word of encouragement, you know, let's keep focused. Let's enjoy the time at home and see this as a time of preparation, that God is preparing us to be useful the moment we step out of our homes again for Him and for His kingdom. Let's pray together. Lord, I honor You for the wonderful privilege we have to be together this morning, to spend time together. Just, I'm thinking about Paul that wrote and he said, "I have a gift and I want to encourage you and you might encourage me." But I'm just giving this word out there this morning for the saints, the my fellow brothers and sisters in Oxygen Life, that they will be reminded of Your goodness and Your faithfulness. And as we are at home, Lord Jesus, that we will truly focus on surrendering ourselves to You yet again, allowing You to change the way we think and enjoying the general everyday chores again. Being healthy, being able to take out the garbage, being able to wash the dishes, being able to prepare food, being able just to sit down and love the people around me. Being able to sit down all by myself with you and enjoying your company. Lord, I honor you for the wonderful, wonderful privilege we have to be able, yeah, just to know that and allowing ourselves to focus on you. And I pray this, Jesus, in your wonderful name. Amen. Guys, may you be blessed and have a wonderful day today.